Change detection is a mechanism that tracks changes in the application state and synchronizes those changes with the application view. Each frontend framework like Svelte, Vue.js, SolidJS, and others, they have their own implementation of change detection mechanism. But in this video, we will focus on Angular and we will have a look at how it is implemented there. It is quite a complex logic, especially because we're going to investigate Angular internals quite a lot. So I decided, or actually you decided, that it is better to split it into a video series. So there will be three videos, at least three videos. The first one is dedicated to view checking process. This is the topic we cover in this video. The second video will be dedicated to automated view checking and Zone.js. So we will have a look at this library and learn which role plays it in the overall change detection mechanism in Angular. And the third video will be about on push change detection strategy. What is that? How it works? And of course, we'll have a look at different scenarios with on push change detection strategy. So if you don't want to miss those videos, it is always a great idea to be subscribed to this channel and enable all the notifications. If you are first time on my channel, my name is Dmytro Mrzenski, and here you can find a lot of advanced Angular tutorials that you can check out later. But now let's get started and learn more about change detection in Angular. I personally split the change detection process into two sub-processes. Sub-process number one I call view checking. It is when Angular view is being synchronized with the corresponding data model. Sometimes saying change detection, developers mean exactly this sub-process. But I will be using the term view checking in order to avoid any misunderstandings. Then, subprocess number two, it's the automatic execution of process one. What is interesting is that this second process could be disabled, and this is exactly what I'm going to do right now, so we can focus exclusively on the view checking process so far. It can be easily done inside the main TS file by providing the following configuration. More about Zone.js and its role in change detection process, I will talk more about it in the second video, but for now, everything you have to know is that the following configuration prevents the automatic running of the view checking process, and currently it is kind of under manual control. So before we dive into really crazy stuff, let's have a look at this process at the high level. So it will be very beginner friendly description of a view checking process. We have some component, any component, doesn't matter. It consists of like many things, but we will focus on two of them. The component class, which represents the component data model, right? And the template, which represents the component view. Usually component views are not static, and we usually render some values from the data models there in the view, right? Also, data model value can be used as an input value for other components, or depending on the model value, we can also create or destroy other views using directives like ngif, ng4, and others. In order to connect those values from data model with the view, we use such a thing called data bindings. There are multiple types of bindings. I don't want to name all of them, but the most well-known are string interpolation, property binding, event bindings, etc. All those bindings are of interest for the Angular change detection mechanism, because changes in those bindings, they have direct impact on how and what in the component view has to be rendered. So imagine, like, after some time, the state of the component data model changes. So now the model is out of sync with the corresponding view, and we have to perform view checking process in order to synchronize the new data model state with the corresponding view. And since we disabled the automatic view checking, we have to kick off this process manually. If you work with Angular for some time, probably you know about such a guy as change detector ref. And it has a method called detect changes that actually allows you manually trigger the view checking process, and you have to call this method every time when any property that is used in the component view is changing. Once the detect changes is triggered, what does Angular? Angular goes through component view bindings and updates the view according to the new values. So if Angular sees that the binding value is a function, it will execute this function in order to retrieve a value. If Angular sees that the pipe is used in the binding, then it will execute the transform method of the pipe in order to retrieve the final value, the transformed value, right? Pipes, they have some nuances, pure pipes. And if you want to learn more, check out my old but still informative video. The hint will be there. I would highly recommend you to check it out. But in general, the algorithm looks like that. But this process that I described, this view checking process, it happens not only for the current component view. Angular does this check recursively for the whole view subtree calling conditionally corresponding lifecycle hooks like ng on changes, ng do check, ng after view checked, and others. So basically, we can conclude that if we run detect changes method for the root component like app component, the view checking will be performed for the whole application view tree. So that was the high level overview of the view checking process, and now it's time for deep dive. So take a breath and let's get started. Oh, wait a second. I bet you use Angular forms in your application. My question: would you like to become a real expert in this topic? If yes, I would highly recommend you my last video course about advanced Angular forms. It is more than 10 hours of in-depth videos about this topic, and check out what you will learn from it. In just a few easy sections, you will be guided through most of the template-driven and reactive forms features, so you can create two advanced and interactive forms that will impress everyone and leave you feel proud of your work. But that's not all. The course strongly focuses on custom form controls implementation, so you will learn a lot about control value accessor and how it is used by Angular under the hood. You will get to build custom form controls like a rating picker and a simple text editor, both of which support template-driven and reactive forms, as well as, you know, validations and other form control features, of course. In addition, you will master a really complex component in the third section. Here I'm talking about a drop-down component that supports option filtering, multi-selection, and accessible keyboard navigation. With my step-by-step guidance, you will be able to build this advanced form control very easy. Already impressive, isn't it? But even that is not all. In the remaining course sections, you will learn how to create Angular forms dynamically from JSON config and which architecture solution can help make it scalable and maintainable in the future. In the last section, you will learn how to manage validation errors globally, so you can dynamically render error messages for invalid controls without generating a ton of boilerplate in your component template. So, enroll right now and let's take your form building skills to a completely new level. The link to the course and discounts will be in the video description. Alright, so let's get back to our change detection topic. First thing you have to learn is that components that you usually see in your source code, they look quite different after the compilation. Important here is that the component template isn't represented as an HTML anymore. Now it is a function. This function can be executed in two modes. The first mode is creation mode, which creates the DOM nodes we define in the component template. The second mode is update mode. In this mode, the template function is called every time when component view check happens. Here you can see that each binding has a corresponding function that knows how to update this particular binding, and during the view checking process, this function will be executed. But this is just a part of the puzzle. There are different types of views: the root view, the component view, and embedded view. And those views, they're represented as some specific data structures. So the component view and embedded views, they're represented by one class called viewRef, and the instance of this class is being created for every component view or embedded view. If you forgot, the embedded view can be created by the create embedded view method, which comes from the view container ref. Then the root view is represented as a root view ref class, which extends the view ref, and you can think about it as about the container for other view refs. And this container, this root view ref, is created when you create dynamically some component. It can happen, for instance, during the bootstrapping process when the root app component is created, or when you create component using create component method that comes from the view container ref. What is also interesting about those two data structures is that they both implement the interface of change detector ref. So both can trigger change detection using the detect changes method. And in fact, when you inject the change detector ref in your component, you inject the viewRef instance for the corresponding component. I don't want to go into the wormhole of these data structures, but there are a couple of things you have to know about them. So these data structures have such a thing called context, which contains the reference to the corresponding component class, or the context could be an object that you provide when you create an embedded view. The second fact is that this viewRef instance contains the reference to the component template function, which you already saw a couple of minutes ago. And this template function takes the context I just mentioned as a value source for the bindings. Okay, and when you call detect changes on any of these classes, it triggers the function called refresh view that actually performs the view checking process. Here you can see that the template function is being executed in the update mode, and the current context, current values, they are provided also to this function. And also you can see that it refreshes also the embedded views, does a lot of other stuff like running check hooks like ng-do-check and others. And again, I don't want to go into the execution order of lifecycle hooks because it is quite a big topic, and it was to create a separate video about that. But anyway, if you follow down a little bit here below, you can also see that the refresh child components function is called. And if we go into this function, you can see that it calls again the refresh view function, but this time for all component children. And then this process just recursively repeats. All right, so this is how the view checking process happens. But the last thing for today, I would like to show you how the initial view checking process is being triggered, because despite we disable the automatic view checking process by providing the noop zone.js, the initial view checking has been executed anyway, so our bindings, as you can see, render the proper initial values. So when Angular does it? Well, the initial view checking happens as a part of application bootstrapping process. We already did a bit more detailed investigation of the bootstrapping process in this video, so I'm not going to repeat myself, so I will jump straight to the point and show you where the initial view checking process was triggered. So there is such an internal Angular service called application ref, which you can, by the way, inject in any of your services if you want. This service has a method called bootstrap, which as an argument takes a component which is supposed to be the root component, actually, right? So here it creates this component dynamically. Then the reference to this component is passed to some load component method, where the component host view will be added to some array of views. And the value of this host view, by the way, it is the instance of the root view ref class, which is created for, as I said, each dynamically created component. And once this view is registered, there the very interesting method tick is called. Here you can see that inside we iterate through root views and call detect changes method. And since the detect changes is called for the root view, the view checking process will be executed recursively for the entire component tree. So in such a way, the initial change detection will be executed. All right, guys, that's it. I hope you learned a lot from this video, and don't forget that this is just the first part, and in the second one, we will do the similar deep dive into Zone.js. We'll see how it looks under the hood as well. And if you like what I'm doing, please share this video with your colleagues and friends, leave your comments, and of course subscribe to my other social media profiles, where I publish also some small Angular tips that could be useful for you as well. If you would like to support my channel, you can enroll in one of my Angular courses. In such a way, you can support my channel and encourage me to proceed to create such a content, and also you can get cool knowledge which will help you definitely in your career as an Angular developer. Otherwise, I wish you a productive week ahead, stay safe, and see you in the next video.